In this tutorial, we will learn about custom image cropping just like we do in Adobe Photoshop using the magic wand tool. As you might already know that PowerPoint only supports picture cropping in rectangular form. If you select a picture and move to the picture format tab, and then click the crop command, then you are only able to crop in rectangular mode using the handlers that appear around the picture. But what if you need to freely select and crop a specific part of the picture? The crop to shape command can only crop the picture under the specified shape. Later, you can use the fill to crop everything outside the shape or the fit command to fit the picture inside the shape while maintaining the original picture aspect ratio. Then you have the aspect ratio feature, which is nothing but the predefined areas for the cropping in a rectangular form. So, what can we do to crop a picture freely and have only the specific parts of the picture that we need? Let's first talk about the viewers using an older version of PowerPoint, like 2007. Another aspect is to draw a freeform shape around the area in the picture that you want to keep. Go to the Insert tab, and from the Shapes drop-down menu, choose Freeform Shape. Now, start drawing a shape around the area of the picture that you want to keep. While adding points around the picture, if by mistake you added a wrong point, then you can use the backspace key to remove that point without the need of starting from scratch. Once you have the shape ready, it's time to fill in the picture inside that shape. So, select the picture and use the copy command from the Home tab. Now, right-click the shape and choose the Format Shape command from the context menu. From the Fill section, choose Picture or Texture Fill, and then from the Picture Source type choose Clipboard. As we copied the entire picture, which is larger than the shape size, it may not correctly fit inside the shape that we have drawn. That is when you can try using the Fill command from the Crop drop-down menu of the Picture Format tab, and then adjust the position of the picture to fit within the shape. The other method that you can use is to first crop the picture in rectangular form and remove the unnecessary part. Then use the copy command from the Home tab, and then open Shape Format to fill the picture inside the shape. That way, you might not need to use the fill command and the picture will get perfectly filled inside the shape. Later, you can use the No Outline command from Shape Format to remove the outline around the shape. If the filled picture inside the shape doesn't seem perfect to use, then you can also use the Edit Points command from the Shape Format and then adjust the points to keep the area that you want. Later, you can also use the Glow command from the Picture Effects drop-down menu of the Picture Format tab to remove any sharp edges around the picture. If you are using the latest version of PowerPoint, then you can also get the same results using the Merge Shapes, Intersect command. The method will remain the same as first you need to draw a shape around the area of the picture that you want to keep using the Freeform Shape tool. Then select the picture first, hold down the Shift key, and then select the shape that you have drawn. From the Shape Format tab, use the Intersect command from the Merge Shapes drop-down menu, and there you have the cropped results that you want. Use the Glow command from the Picture Effects to remove the sharp edges around the picture. For some pictures, which have only a single color in the background, you can also use the Set Transparent Color command from the Color drop-down menu of Picture Format. But that works best with pictures having a single background color and might not be useful in all cases. Finally, for some pictures, you can also try using the Remove Background tool of Picture Format and then start marking the areas that you want to keep or remove. We have also published a detailed tutorial on using Remove Background tool and the link of that video is given in the cards in the video description. You can go and check it out. The best methods to crop a picture freely could either be using the Intersect command or Fill Picture inside the shape. So, I hope you will find this tutorial informative, and you might have learned something new. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting. Subscribe to our channel and turn on the notifications as there are a lot more tutorials to come. Thanks a lot for watching the video and have a great weekend.